Welcome friends, in previous session we had already discussed about the elements, and somehow I had showed you how you can put the elements and the saved rows. But let us discuss what is the structure of our website builder tool. So there are mainly three aspects. The first is the row. It is the main container of a particular section on your page. Whether it may be a testimonial section, you need to have a row. And if you want to change from three column to four column, you need to have a separate row. So row is basically the main container or a particular section on a page. Then comes the column. Now column actually divides the row into vertical segment like three column, four column, or maybe two column, etc. And the third is module or element. And they are the actual contents, maybe images, text, video boxes, testimonials, info box, and whatever content you want to add. So let's understand with visual graphics that how the website builder structure works. So first and foremost, if you want to add any content, you need to have a row. So once you add a row, then the row is blank. I mean, you can provide a color to your row, or maybe an image to your row. So let us say you have inserted a blank row, and then we have inserted the content inside the row. So in the row setting, we have selected a background image and we have provided the background image to the row. Still, it is only a row. After that, we decided to divide this row into three columns. So they are basically columns, and this is a three column structure. So column itself can act as a sub row, and columns can have their own backgrounds. You can see there are backgrounds given to the column, and they are also transparent, so you can also provide opacity. And just like you provided image to the row, you can also provide image or color as a background to the row, or sorry, to the column. And then comes the actual contents. So first there is a row, then there are columns, and on that individual columns you can add your actual modules or elements. So either you can add the saved templates and elements that we have, or you can create from the scratch. And this is the structure, or we can say the technical part, and this is what your output actually looks like. So there is a row. Inside that row we have a background image, and then we have three columns, and you can't see the column because they are divided and there is no background in the column, and then you put up your actual contents. So this is the structure of how our website builder works. Now let me show you on the live page. For that we'll go to pages and select any random page just for an educational purpose. Let us say consultancy, then magnet marketing website builder. Let's open it in new tab. Now you can see there is nothing on this page, no row, no columns, no elements. Now we'll go to row, and then by default we can add one row, two columns, three columns, and four columns. So I'll select two columns. Now you can see these are basically columns, and then the black border you are actually looking is their parent row. And then once you hover, it will turn blue. Then go to row settings. You can make it full width, and then you can go down and select background image or color. So here I'll select any random color, there it is, and then save. So you can see the dark green color, that is actually a row, and these are basically columns. Now once you click on the columns anywhere, it will open up a dialog box, and that will have settings with respect to columns. Now if you want to give a background color to your columns, you can simply give color, and in color let's say I want white, so that looks good. And if you want, you can give opacity, but opacity looks good when you have an image in the background. So let us go to the row settings, and instead of dark green we will have one image. Instead of color we'll select photo, select photo, and let's see what suits to this page. Okay, this looks good. Select photo, photo has been selected, and then you can provide an overlay, and let's take some more blue and then save. Now as I was discussing, see, this is a column, this first column and second column, and once you click over any area of the column, it opens up the column, and then you can provide the column width and, you know, anything you want. And let me reduce the opacity. Okay, save. Then comes the actual contents. So you have to go to modules, and there are two modules. One is standard module and another is Magnet Marketing Pro module. So I will encourage you to first search. Now let us say if I want a text with heading, so I'll type in heading. So now there is a heading in basic modules, as well as if you scroll down there is a heading in content module. So I recommend if there are duplicate things, you just go through the MM Pro modules. Now go to heading, click, and then drop, and then there is a heading, and then there is a description, and then save. Now if you click on the column, it will definitely open the column settings, but since you have added the content to the column, now if you click on the same column, it will open up the content, that is the heading module, and not the column settings. Now once you add a content or a module to the column, again I am repeating, once you add let us say any content to the column, you can't directly click on that and have a column setting. You will get the content tab only. So I guess I have added video instead of photo. So I can see I have added the photo. Select a photo, and okay, select, save. Now you see, these were columns, and when the columns were empty and you click on anywhere on the column, it had opened up the column settings. But now whenever you click on anywhere on the column, it will definitely open the content module. Now to access a column after you add a module, you just hover, and then you will see this column settings, edit column, and then go to column settings. So this is the way to again open up the column settings once you add the module or content. Now in the column setting, I'll select equalize column heights, and yes, so it will equalize the column heights, and you can set the alignment to middle, center, or whatever you want. And then at any point of time, if you want to remove the background, you can remove it, then save. Then once again, I'll go to contents, and you can see typography, and you can set text color to white. You can also add this color, and it will be added as a preset. And next time if you wanted to have a color, just go to preset and you can select the preset. And this is h3, let us make it h1. You can also give the font size you want. Then in description, let's make it white as well. This time I'll select the saved color. I'll select Open Sans, that's the font I recommend, and semi bold, and again I need to provide color. That's it, and then save, and then done, and then publish. Now if I want to add another four column structure to the same row, then I can do so. You can add inside this, you can add inside this, you can add here, you can add beneath it, or you can create an altogether outside element if you don't want the same image as a background. So I'll show you what is inside. So this inside, so your contents will be added inside the same row. I mean, if you want to have a same background, then you should insert here. You can delete it, and if you want to have a separate background, you can just click over here and then go outside of this row, and now you have another row. Then you can add contents. Apart from that, you can also use our saved contents. Now let us say text with header, so text format 1, and then I'll add at the bottom, and then I can pick up the individual module, and then again I can add anywhere I want, and then again change the text color and the formats. There it is. Now if you want to increase the height of the row, again you need to go to row settings, and then you can define margin if you want to have space outside, and if you want to have space inside, I mean if you want to increase the height, you just add the padding to, let us say from the top it should be 50 and from the bottom it should be 50, or you can increase to 100 and from the bottom you can increase to 80. You can play around with your own designs and with your own numbers. Save, then done, and then publish. So this is how the structure for row, column and modules works. But again friends, I will advise, instead of using everything from scratch, I mean once you practice on each and every module it will be easier, but till then we have almost everything ready for you. Even expert web designers at our team, Ruchi, is doing a great job, and she has created all these elements. Even experts are using the same elements, because why you are wasting time on, you know, setting up the row, setting up the heights and setting up the margins and padding. So just go to the elements.magnetmarketing.in. You just have a look whatever you want, and then just click and drop. That is, again this is a row inside a row, and then these are the columns. You can change as per your requirement. Again let us make it as full width, and you can as also make content as full width. It's up to you. Then publish. That's it. So friends, this was the technical structure for Magnet Marketing's website builder. Hope you understand how rows, columns and modules works. This concludes our session. Thank you very much.